Hello everyone, I hope all of you will be fine. I'm Dr. Faisal. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to discuss about second part of eukaryotic cell structure and functions. In the previous lecture, we discussed about different parts of the eukaryotic cell structures, and today we are going to discuss our first part, cytoskeleton. So what is cytoskeleton? Cytoskeleton is the structure which is the skeleton present in the cell cytoplasm, and it helps in the anchor organelles, and it helps in the cellular structure support, and it also helps in the enabling cell shape and changes. There are two types of the cytoskeleton. One is the microfilaments and the second one is the microtubules. Here you can see that microfilaments allow the movement of molecules in the cytoplasm, and microtubules maintain shape of the cell and enable movement of molecules within the cell. This is the structure of the cytoskeleton which is present in the cytoplasm. This is the rough endoplasmic reticulum, and here you can see this is the microtubule, and these are ribosomes attached with the microtubules. This structure is the microfilament structure which is present in the cytoplasm, and this is the overall model of the cytoskeleton present in the cytoplasm. Another important microorganism is fungus, and fungi or funguses is any member of the group of eukaryotic organisms that include microorganisms such as yeast and molds, as well as the more familiar mushrooms. Here you can see some of the examples of the mushrooms and other microorganisms, and these organisms are classified as kingdom, separate kingdom, which is separate from the other eukaryotic life kingdom of plants and animals. So fungi are heterotrophs. They are aerobic. In aerobic example is mold, in facultative anaerobic example is yeast. Here you can see example of yeast cells, and here you can see example of molds. So most fungi are decomposers, while few are parasites of the plants and animals. Decomposers are those organisms which decompose different types of pollutants or different types of substrates, and a number of their serious fungal infections are increasing day by day due to the fungal cell. In this figure you can see this is the septate hyphae and this is the septum in the hyphae, and these are the pore and these are nuclei present in the hyphae. This is the cell wall, and this hyphae is non-septate, it don't have any septate structure. And here is the growth of a hyphae from a spore, and how the spore is germinated into the hyphae. Here are some examples of different fungal cells, different fungi. Here are some characteristics of fungi. Fungi have hyphae, there are filaments of the cells, and mostly are septate, some are non-septate. They have mycelium, which is mass of the hyphae. Molds is one of the type of the fungus, and they are mostly filamentous. Yeast are non-filamentous, and they are mostly unicellular fungi. And some fungal spores differ from the bacterial spores because they are formed from the aerial hyphae, and growth in the they can grow in the acidic environment, in the low moisture content also, and high osmotic pressure environments. So they like to grow under these conditions, and they like to metabolize complex carbohydrates, for example lignin. Here are some economic effects of fungi. Saccharomyces cerevisiae helps in the bread production, in the wine production, and trichoderma in the cellulase enzyme production, and taxomyces in the production of taxol, and entomophaga helps in the production, helps in the biocontrol as a biocontrol agent, and pacillomyces kills the insects, and also some fungal do mold spoilage, like they spoil some fruit material, oranges and some fungi also can spoil like bread, like Rhizopus is one of the example. Another microbial organism is algae, and mostly they are photoautotrophs, means they can produce their own food, and mostly are present in the ocean in an aquatic environment. And one of the example are diatoms. Diatoms are unicellular, they store energy in the form of oil, and domoic acid, they can produce, some of the diatoms produce domoic acid. It is helpful in the neurological disease. And ingestion of mussels that fed on diatoms also affect birds and sea lions. There is another example of the algae, dinoflagellates. They are plankton, and some produce neurotoxins, which are present in the red tide, and some kills fish, marine mammals and humans, etc. Algae contain green chlorophyll as well as other pigments, which include yellow, red and brown. And these are examples of some of the algae. This first example is the Spirogyra, and the second example is the diatoms, and the third example is the Chlamydomonas. Another type of microorganism, eukaryotic microorganism, is protozoa. These protozoans are unicellular, they are eukaryotic, they are heterotrophs, and they cannot produce their own food. They are large and diverse group, and few are pathogenic microorganisms which cause diseases. They found in the soil, in the water, as normal microbiota in the animals also. Trophozoite is a vegetative form which helps in the feeding and growing. And the reproduction is the asexual reproduction. We have fission, budding, or schizogony, which is a multiple fission. There is also sexual reproduction via conjugation, and some protozoa can produce a cyst that provides protection during adverse environmental conditions. There are medical important protozoa also, like archezoa. So archezoa lake mitochondria, examples are Trichomonas, and Giardia are examples. Microspora, they have no mitochondria and no microtubules, and they cause diarrhea. And another example is Amoebozoa, they move by pseudopodia. Example is Entamoeba, which cause dysentery. And Apicomplexa is one of the example. They are not mobile, they are intracellular. Plasmodium, Toxoplasma and Cryptosporidium are examples. And another type is the Euglenozoa. They are hemoflagellates, and Trypanosoma is one of the example. Here is the structure of Entamoeba or amoeba structure. You can see there are food vacuole, there is nucleus, there are pseudopods, and they move by these pseudopods. Examples are Entamoeba and N. Acantha amoeba are the examples of Amoebozoa. Another type of parasitic helminths are also considered as microbial cells, eukaryotic microbial cells. They are parasitic helminths or animals that are often included within the study of microbiology, because many species of these worms are identified by their microscopic eggs and larvae. And there are two major groups of parasitic helminths. One is the roundworm, and the second one is the flatworm. In the roundworm, there is one of the example Nematoda, and in the flatworm example is Platyhelminthes. Here you can see examples of the roundworm. They are phylum Nematoda. The roundworm is a diverse group containing more than 15,000 species, of which several are important human parasite. And this is example of the roundworm. And these unsegmented worms have full digestive system even when parasitic, and some are common intestinal parasites, and their eggs can sometimes be identified in feces or around the anus of infected individuals. And Ascaris lumbricoides is the largest nematode intestinal parasite found in the humans. Females and may reach lengths greater than 1 meter, and Ascaris lumbricoides is also very widespread. Here is example of Platyhelminthes flatworm. Phylum Platyhelminthes, the Platyhelminthes are flatworms, and this group includes the flukes and tapeworms as medically important parasite. And the flukes, trematodes are non-segmented flatworms. They don't have segments, and they have an oral and the oral sucker. And you can see here in this diagram the oral suckers. This one is the sucker, and here is the oral sucker. And sometimes a second ventral sucker is also present attached to the inner wall of the intestine, lungs, large blood vessels, or the liver. And trematodes have complex life cycles, and often with multiple hosts. Or several important examples are the liver flukes, the intestinal fluke, and the oriental lung flukes. This was all about second part of lecture, eukaryotic cell structure and functions. Thanks for watching this video. If you have any question or comment, please ask or comment in the comment section below. I hope this video is useful for you. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe this channel for upcoming videos. Thank you and see you.